Let's look at how we would interact with Azure SQL Database, the service. Conceptually, everything that connects to the Azure SQL Database service uses a TDS endpoint. And this is true with SQL Server standalone, SQL Server in other forms and fashions. But the most important thing to remember here is that we have this concept of a SQL Server in Azure. This really is just where you would connect your TDS endpoint. And the most important settings here are what the name of it is and the firewall settings. For the purposes of this demo, I just made a firewall setting called all IP addresses that just allows any connection. Now I could go in here and create databases. I already have a database created and modify things, but what I'm going to do is gonna click on this database. I already have a database created, and you'll see that the SQL Server has a child SQL database. Here in the Essentials panel, you'll see the server name. The server name is actually what I use to connect to this. So if I was using a familiar tool like Visual Studio, I can go to Data Connections, Add a Connection, SQL Server, plug in that name, which I must not have copied from the portal. No problem. I'll just go in here, copy that, plug in that name. You have to use SQL Server authentication. So whatever username and password you set when you created that server instance, that's going to be the username and password you set when you connect to this database. And then you can select which database you want to connect to. So I'm going to try the retry database, hit test connection, see if it succeeded. If I hit OK, you'll see very shortly that I have a connection to my database. And is there a master database there? So if I want to use a dynamic management view, I can definitely do that. Here, I used the portal to create a new database with custom data already in it. It's the Adventure Works LT schema and data. But you can see it's just everything I'm used to if I'm already used to interacting with SQL. I can use any sort of tool that I'm already comfortable with. SQL Server Management Studio is built on the same stack. Our IDE is Visual Studio, so I don't really need to show you that, but let me show you another tool I can do this in. A lot of developers use LinkPath to connect with data sources. Since it's just a TDS endpoint, LinkPath doesn't really care. Same thing, SQL authentication. I can display all the databases in a tree view. Hit OK, and there we go. I have two databases here. So you can see I have my dynamic management views, and I have my sales LT schema, and I can get all the products from my sales LT schema, whether or not I want to do that using Link, or if I want to use the SQL language. So let's try that. Select all from sales LT.product. Run it. Forgot to specify my database. Apologies. You can run it, and there you go. I'm able to query it just fine, whether it's a SQL query or whatever tool I choose to use. If I go back to the portal, you'll see very quickly that I can see events, successful connections, failed connections, my database size, I can change the tier, I can enable auditing, which will allow me to store audits of records. I can do dynamic data masking. That allows me to mask data dynamically as it's being put into the database and remove that mask depending upon who's accessing it. You can view database events. And then you can even go and create another database. So here, let me go to the server. I can either go into here and look at my database list, or I can go to New, Data and Storage, and I can choose SQL Database. Now, when I create a new database, one of the most important things is I specify which subscription I want to use, specify a resource group. I'm going to put this in, I have a resource group called Group. I know it's the worst name in the world, but that's fine. And for the server, I can go in here and use my existing server. Now this is a V12 server. If it wasn't a V12, you'll see the previous version listed there, and I have a slightly different icon. I can use a source database, so I can either back up. So this is a quick way if you want to create a database from an existing backup, or I can select sample. And under sample, you'll see VentureWorks LT, or a variant of VentureWorks LT that uses more features that are available in V12 of the Azure SQL Database service. Of course, in order to use an existing server, I need to go ahead and provide my server admin information. So I can call this sample database, hit create, and now essentially what's going to happen is in my retry server, it's going to create a second database. And once that second database is done creating, it will populate right here. So we can interact with this database using the portal to manage it, or we can use familiar tools that we already have. So if we want to create tables, we can do that. We can go here into the master database and do interesting things. If you're using SQL Server Management Studio, you can actually even create databases within there. Even though that's not normally suggested, you can definitely do that.